this end.
As the evening wears on, business at the bar is going very briskly. And two of the bar's major inhabitants are of that breed of man that term themselves half a horse, half an alligator, part of a snapping turtle, and a bit of an earthquake thrown in.
Old Kentuck's the spot! The soil in Kentucky is so rich you can travel under it. The other day I was paddling away on horseback, pretty considerable, through no bottom swamp, when suddenly, what should I see but a white hat getting along in mighty considerable style all alone by itself on top of the mud. So up I rid, and being a bit jeebus, I lifted it up with the butt end of my whip when a feller sung out from underneath it, "Hello, stranger, who told you to knock my head off?" "Why," says I, "what sort of a sample of a man are you? What's come of the rest of you?" "Oh," says he, "I'm not far off, only in the next county. I'm doing beautifully. I got one of the best horses under me that ever burrowed. Claws like a mole. No stopping him. But there's a wagon and horses under me in a mighty bad fix, I reckon. For I heard the driver say a spell ago that one of the team was getting a little tired." "So," says I, "you must be a pretty considerable feller on your own. But you'd better keep your mouth shut or you'll get your teeth sunburned."
So anyway, I says, "So long, stranger. I wish you a pleasant ride, but I'll prognosticate before you get through the next sandbank, you'll burst your bone." Burst your boiler. Boiler. That airs my best story.
Gentlemen and ladies, fair, who graces famous city, just listen if you've time to spare while I rehearse a ditty. And for an opportunity, conceive yourselves quite lucky, for 'tis not often that you see a hunter from Kentucky. Oh, Kentucky, hunters of Kentucky. Oh, Kentucky, hunters of Kentucky. Look at me! I'm the old original iron-jawed, copper-bellied, brass-mounted corpse wanker from the wilds of Kentucky. Look at me! I'm the man they call sudden death and general desolation. I take 19 alligators and a barrel of whiskey for breakfast when I'm in robust health, and a bushel of rattlesnakes and a dead body when I'm ailing. You lay low and hold your breath. I'm about to turn myself loose. Bow your neck and spread. I'm a child of sin. Don't let me get a start. Smoke glass here for all. Don't attempt to look at me with a naked eye. Contemplate me through leather. My flesh crawled over already and my toenails move out of place. I've been sharpening up my thumbnail and I'm gonna go home with somebody's eyeball in my pocket. I'm Hank Wild Horse! Clear Crockett Alligator! And I got no more principles than a yellow suck-egg mule. I'll tell you why. I was riding down the banks of the Mississippi one day when I seen a fella floating down that stream sitting cocked up in the stern of his boat, fast asleep. I hadn't had a fight for as much as 10 days. Felt as though I must cover myself up in a salt barrel to keep so woofy about the head and shoulders. So says I, "Hello, stranger! If you don't take care, your boat will run away with you."
He looked up at me, slantendicular. I looked down on him, slantwise.
He took a chaw of tobacco from his mouth.
Says he, "Mister, I don't value you tantamount to that."
And then he flopped his wings and crowed like a cock. I riz up, crooked my neck, shook my mane, and neighed like a horse. He run his boat foremost ashore. I stopped my wagon and set the triggers. "Mister,"
says he, "I'm the best man. If I ain't, I hope I may be teetotaciously ex-flunctified."
I quit my weight in wildcats and ride straight through a crab-apple orchard on a flash of lightning.
Clear meat axe disposition. What's more, I once backed a bull off a bridge.
"Paw,"
says I, "what do I care for that? I can tow the steamboat up the Mississippi and over the Allegheny Mountains. My father can lick the best man in old Kentuck, and I can lick my father. When I'm good-natured, I weigh about 170 pounds, but when I'm mad, I weigh a ton." With that, I fetched him the regular engine war whoop. Well, out he jumped from his boat. Down I tumbled from my wagon. We come together like two steamboats going 60 miles an hour. He's a pretty severe cold, but no part of a prime into such a fella as me. I put it to him mighty droll. I tickled that varmint till he squealed like a young colt, bellered enough. Swore I was a ripped staver. Says I, "Ain't I a horse?" Says he, "Stranger, you're a beauty anyhow, and if you'd stand for Congress, I'd vote for you next election." Says I, "Would you? I'm the yellow flower of the forest. I'm all brimstone, but the head, and that's acifortis. I can walk like an ox, run like a fox, swim like an eel, yell like an Injun, make love like a mad bull, and swaller a man whole, if you'll grease his head and pin his ears back. And if a daring foe annoys, whate'er his strength and force is, we'll show him that Kentucky boys are alligator horses. Oh, Kentucky, hunters of Kentucky. Oh, Kentucky, hunters of Kentucky." So you wanted to hear a song historic.